Malo lele, talo falava, kiorana, nisan bulaminaka, maloni. Warm Pacific greetings. Tenakoto, tenakoto, tenakoto katoa. Chairperson and members of the Select Committee, I am very grateful for the opportunity and the privilege to speak with you today. I bring to you warm greetings on behalf of my people, my Pacific people. We acknowledge your hard work for Aotearoa. Malo Opito, thank you very much. I represent my Pacific people. I speak on behalf of many Pacifica churches, church ministers and communities of leaders, youth leaders, parents, caregivers, lay people, Pacific health professionals of doctors, nurses, health administrators, and leaders within our Tongan and Pacific communities in New Zealand. We strongly oppose the conversion practice prohibition legislation bill. We strongly oppose the conversion practices prohibition legislation bill. My name is Dr. Ate Moala. I am a trained and had graduated from Otago Medical School and have worked as a medical doctor in New Zealand and in the Pacific for 34 years and still going. I'm married and a mother of three beautiful children. I am an auntie, honorary mama, and mentor to many children and young people in New Zealand and in the Pacific. We are alarmed that this bill has been introduced and pushed through so quickly during a crisis of COVID lockdown when New Zealand was in level 4 lockdown and still in lockdown. Our Pacific people are busy trying to look after their families because of the fear of COVID. Having to do a submission to your committee at this time, it's the last thing that is on our mind, but we have to come. I'm coming on the behalf of my people. Our strong opposition to this bill is due to the fact that the implication of this proposed bill, if passed, are so chilling and very unsafe for our Pacific people, our families, our communities, and our whānau, our beautiful children. This bill, if passed, will unravel. It will destroy the fabric and strong foundation of our Pacific families and New Zealand society. We fully oppose this bill because our parental rights are being abused and we will be criminalized under this bill. We are concerned that there are no clear guidelines around parental rights, no age guidelines as to when a child can decide they want to transition or to change their gender. As parents, health professionals, and leaders of our communities, we have lovingly walked alongside our young people, including our own family members who had gender dysphoria and their families for many years. This bill, under this bill, we will not be free to function in our role as healers. The health and healing service we offer our people is holistic. We treat body, mind, soul, and spirit. We offer our medical treatment, counseling and psychological support combined with our prayers, our love as we walk with our children and young people as they go through gender dysphoria together with their families. But this bill will make us criminals as parents and caregivers, teachers, health professionals, youth and church leaders. We are concerned about the very heavy-handed approach of this bill that will drive us out of our job and profession. We didn't train to be health professional and church ministers only to be forced by a bill to go against everything that we know and believe to the core of our being as Pacific people. This bill will force us either to exit or be put in jail for 3 to 5 years. Pacific people will miss out. New Zealand will lose a very valuable resource of people who will not yield. We will not yield to this agenda that this bill is proposing. This bill has the potential to make us criminal if we try to help our children and young people who may be confused about their gender identity. Because if we counsel any child or teenager who may want to consider a gender transition against their wish, we would be liable to be criminalized in this bill. Because if we tell the truth to our young people or the children, if we tell them that 80 to 95% of those with gender dysphoria will revert and accept their biological natal sex by the end of puberty. If we tell them that under this bill, welcome to jail. Hundreds of years, gender dysphoria is known as part of pubertal development process. What is new, though, you may not be aware of, what is new is that this transgender ideology has been pushed upon our young people, especially our beautiful teenage girls, as young as 10 to 12 year olds. This transgender ideology has been pushed through TikTok, social media, and transgender clinics that deliberately alienate our loving and caring parents from helping their children. Committee, this is cruel. It is brutal and inhumane to give these young people who may be confused about their gender identity, and while their brain development is not yet complete, to put them on puberty hormone blockers that would arrest their pubertal development. This bill alienates us, parents, leaders, doctors, if we counsel them against their wishes to transition. These loving parents in our caring Pacifica communities will be deemed criminals under this proposed bill. Our children are very vulnerable under this proposed bill because while they are young, they are very vulnerable to being coerced. This bill, it will make our children, it put our children to be very vulnerable because they will be coerced, they will be tempted to do this, you know, they have to go on these hormone blockers, and 100% of these will eventually take cross-sex hormones and proceed to transgender surgical procedures that will harm them irreversibly, emotionally, physically, and mentally. Under this bill, these dangerous medical procedures can be done without the parents' consent and support. There is no long-term data available, I hope you know that, on these puberty blockers and the irreversible impact on brain and bone development. Studies have shown that 100% of children on hormone blockers progress to cross-sex hormones, and we don't have the reliable long-term data on the efficacy and safety of this treatment. So it's irresponsible and dangerous to experiment on our young children with these high-risk medical procedures that will lead to irreversible outcomes, including infertility. This bill promotes that gender-affirming therapy is the only acceptable approach for gender dysphoria. We know that it's still very experimental. We do not know the long-term outcome of this experimental therapy. There's already a growing number of those who have reversed. Let me just finish.
Sure.
There's ruling
overseas.
Yeah, let me finish. It's okay. I just haven't finished. Due to the recent ruling of the UK High Court, the NHS have stopped initiating of this treatment under 16, children under 16 without a court order and without a review. That's why doctors like me, many doctors, adopt the wait and see approach for gender dysphoria rather than harmful puberty blockers, chest binders, and cross-sex hormones, which locks the children into transgender. Puberty blockers and cross hormones, hear me, are not harmless. They are not fully reversible. The long-term evidence is not yet available. Can I just say to you, as Pacific people, we have not been consulted about this bill before it was carried out. We are disappointed that the way this process lacks integrity. It has not been transcribed into Pacifica languages. Chris Farfoy and our MPs somehow forgot to tell the government that Pacific languages is our primary languages. English is not our first language. So how can we engage in a process that alienates us? Our Pacific communities and leaders want this government and our Pacific MPs to know that we have been betrayed by this government. We have been alienated by a process that has been rushed, and it does not reflect the recent downright apology. We have been alienated again and again. It does not add up. The loud messages from Labor government to my people is that our voice does not matter. Our people does not matter. Our children does not matter to you. But know this, we will not be silent. For the sake of our children, for the sake of their futures, for the sake of the sacrifice that our parents and our grandparents came to Aotearoa to do, many years ago, they came and did the four F's. They did the forest, they did the forestries, they clean your floors, they did the fisheries, and then they end up exhausted with premature funerals. For their sake and for their sacrifice, we will fight. Thank you for the privilege to speak to you today. God bless you all. Mala Obito.